Spanning 1,100 square miles, the Sacramento-San Joaquin Delta is the hub of the state's water supply. At the Skinner Fish facility near Byron,
a lot of people depend on this water.
Water for 27 million Californians and hundreds of thousands of acres of farmland passes through these louvers.
How's this one look on the front?
They ensure no fish make it into their pumps, but those protection efforts are being undermined.
You see any mussels on there?
Early this year, golden mussels began clogging the system.
They have the ability to completely close that off.
It is thick.
Tanya Valtuzin leads the invasive mussel program for the Department of Water Resources.
Might just start up in this area here and then just fill in.
She says golden mussels are affecting their facilities across the state.
It is overwhelming when I think about the scale of the problem. We've marked individual mussels and we'll be tracking them.
They're looking at all potential solutions on the table, one of which might come from a lab a little further north in Yolo County.
Now, invasive species are amazing. They're horrible, but they're also amazing in that they're genetically built to invade quickly and have really high reproductive rates.
Pam Marrone has studied invasive species extensively.
Got a number of things.
From invasive plants to quagga and zebra mussels, her company, the Invasive Species Corporation, works to find fixes.
There's a real opportunity to find safer biological solutions for these types of pests.
Already, she's created a product that kills quagga and zebra mussels. Zequinox is being used across the country.
So we have to learn about the feeding behavior of the golden mussels to do the same.
Now, she and her team are modifying that product.
These are different formulations of Zequinox.
To better target golden mussels.
There's definitely some that are uptaking the Zequinox up here.
Their experiment shows Zequinox can kill golden mussels, but not at as high of a rate as they'd like.
We're confirming that they are much hardier and tougher than the zebra and quagga mussels.
So they're fine-tuning, working to get their product out the door and into waterways across the world, all with the hope of slowing the spread.
Unfortunately, once they're invaded in a big way like they are, it's not going back to normal. That's why prevention is so much better than management, because it's so hard to eradicate an invasive species.
The species spanning countries and continents. The implications now hitting close to home.
This is going to be our new normal in California, unfortunately.
Peyton Headley, KCRA 3 News.
Well, earlier this year, Marrone was inducted into the National Inventors Hall of Fame for her work. She says that they're hoping to have generation 2 of what's called Zequinox ready by next year.